in front of somebody. Somebody spit out in front of me. Come on, we get that all the time. And then they go slow.
Real slow.
Somebody cut you off. You cut somebody else off. Somebody cut you off. And it happened just like that. Something might be that simple. Right there in the same track. Pass your boom, boom. Then God will show you. You just cut somebody off.
Can't say nothing then.
Then you can't say nothing. If you allow the word of God to minister to you, amen?
Yeah.
But we can sell out behind that. We didn't realize, oh, why they cut me off? Two nights before, you did it. And you probably called that person a curse worse than you thought a curse word. Come on, somebody. But we, if you're so good, you're going to reap good. If you're so evil, you're going to reap evil. And if it don't get your head, it'll get your kid or your grandkid. We got some stuff we reaping right now that our foreparents done reap. Done so. Y'all better believe that. You better believe it. For he that soweth in the flesh shall reap corruption. But he that soweth in the spirit shall spiritually reap life everlasting. And let us not be weary in well doing. Before y'all came in, like I was telling you, going to a neighbor house, checking on that neighbor every day, and ain't no benefit coming. I done seen people that done built relationship with older people, that done built relationship with older people, and older people done left them everything they had. Had children. But that one individual that kept going by them, kept going by them, yeah, kept checking on that person. They be done changed their will and gave it to that person. I done seen it happen. I done been in the medical field long time to see where people give their children, don't give their children, but a friend. Because that friend came, took them to the store, they didn't get tired, they didn't get tired. Yeah, your body get tired. But they didn't never tell that person. But even though they was tired, they kept on coming. They kept on sowing. They kept on sowing. So after a while, when the time when that person died, oh, they reap what? They reap the harm.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Or just because the church ain't going the way it's supposed to be, them that come sweep the flow, everybody that's going to sweep the flow, that person that sweep that flow, and keep on moving and keep on doing it, no matter if they don't get no help, but they keep on doing it. Oh, baby, the word of God tells you what? What does it tell you? You might be the only one. You might be the only one, but the word of God tells you in due season, we shall reap if we faint not.
Shall we?
It didn't say might. Come on. What did y'all see?
Shall
we?
As we have, therefore, opportunity, let us do good unto who? Some men.
Oh.
What word of God says?
Oh.
Do good to your family. Do good to your sister. Do good to your brother. And don't worry about the rest. What the word of God say? Do good to who?
All men.
All men. In the nursing home field. We get, some of us get favorite people. Amen? Some of us get people we'd rather deal with, and some of us get people that we won't rather deal with. But what the word of God said, do good to who? So tomorrow, y'all that's in the nursing field, y'all ain't got to tell them, but just go grab them by the hand and repent and ask God to forgive you for how you treat them. Amen. Some of y'all will be doing that all day. No, just play. But just go get them. Oh, just rub them on the shoulder and repent. Oh, for real. Because the word of God said do. And those are the ones that he tells us to see about. Widowers and kids.
And orphans.
And orphans. The one that ain't got nobody. That's who God tells you to treat good. It's an extra verse in the Bible for this. Hey, Miss. Oh, no.
Poor
Phil. Poor Phil. Oh, Jesus. Hey, man. No, but you know, the Porterfield, my girl, me and Porterfield ain't have no problem. Amen. But I went in there and did it just like Porterfield wanted. Ain't have no problem. Well, she come in there and think you got a frown on up your face. She finna put it to you. If she feel like you got tension, oh, she finna put it to you. Then finna go tell on you. Then write everything down. She
finna throw some
gas. Amen. Oh, Mr. Powell was another one like that. Oh, Lord. You remember Mr. Powell? But see, no, he wasn't okay with everybody. He wanted you to put something, no, look, this big. Remember that? You got to capitalize him.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
You might be finding the skin trying to put it. Lord help us and help us all. It says, let us do good to all men, especially to them who are what?
Household of faith.
Oh. He said, especially. What the word of God say? Especially to those in the household of faith. See, that right there where a person don't learn that our church family supposed to come, if our real family ain't living the word of God or doing what God saying. If Tasha called me and Needham calling me at the same time, or somebody's not in the household of faith, I'm supposed to go to which one? The one that's in the household of faith. And see, that's why people don't understand when you have a real church family that where you're supposed to go. Because it said, especially to those, did I say this? This thing wrote a long time ago.
Yeah.
And then he said, ye see how large a letter I have wrote unto you with my own hand, as many as receive to be a fair show in the flesh, that they constrain you to be circumcised. Only thus thou shalt suffer persecution for the cross of Christ. Don't be weary in whatever you're doing. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Get back into reading your word of God. Get back into practicing faith talk and the faith walk. I sat the other day and I listened to myself. Not verbally, but I listened to myself. And I began to see the things. When the last time I stepped out of faith? When the last time we walked out on faith? When the last time you believed God for something big? When the last time when they say no, you believed that God was going to say yes? I remember there was a time we was foolish enough to believe God for anything in this ministry. Come on, can I get one witness?
Yeah.
If God said it, we was looking for it the next day. Come on.
Amen.
And then we was in such a realm of one time, every day God was blessing us. Y'all remember then?
Amen. Amen.
Man, we was, everybody was getting stuff.
Right.
Then we get comfortable. We got weary because it seems like even though God was blessing us, everybody around us was getting ahead of us. Come on. Everybody around us was getting away with stuff. And that's what the problem with us as black people, we think everybody else is getting ahead of us just because they was able to go out at the club and made it back in. You got some people that snuck out at the club, didn't make it back to Sunday morning service.
Sure did.
What you call it? Remind